Hi, I'm Krista Valdez. I am here with Mr. Nathan Parsons, who I met moments ago. You look nothing like this. Welcome, Nathan.
Thank you.
How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Yourself?
Wonderful. Despite this lovely weather, we decided to showcase
the windstorm that we have going on.
Yeah, but I just assured you that the rest of the towns surrounding us are very lovely, so I hope you stay and enjoy some of the sights while you're here.
I plan to.
Okay, so you're here through April? Is that right?
Yes.
And can you tell me about how you came into this role?
Well, I first got this script probably about a month and a half ago. And at the time, it was sort of a read for interest kind of thing. So I read through it and I loved the script immediately. I never really heard anything about it. Mm-hmm. Until last week, they called me up on Thursday and they said, hey, can you get the same favor the weekend? And
excellent.
So, okay, let's do it.
So you're ready to roll?
Ready to roll.
Wonderful. You look great and you look totally prepared. What interests you about the script?
Well, I love Westerns. I'm from Texas, so I grew up with cowboys and I grew up riding, and that's always been sort of an iconic thing in my life. And, you know, doing film and TV, you rarely get an opportunity to do a really good Western.
Yeah.
You know, it's not the 80s anymore. You know, you don't have Clint Eastwood running around, or, you know, John Wayne even before that. And so it's hard to find really captivating scripts that are Westerns and that have a chance to come and actually distribute.
Excellent. So you're tied into your character, and what can you tell us about your character? I don't want you to give anything away, but...
His name is James McCord. He is a US Marshal. This is right after the Civil War, and he served in the 12th Mass, the 12th Massachusetts Regiment for the Union. And so he's a war veteran, and comes out west looking for his little brother, who has written him a letter, and when he gets here, he discovers his whole... like a conspiracy.
A little bit of trouble out there.
Yeah, a little bit. And then you get into all the good gunslinging and all the fun.
Do you know if you're going to be on horseback at all?
I've been on horseback a lot
already. Oh, excellent.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see that.
Yeah, it's been fun.
So you enjoy that, and being from Texas, no problem for you?
Yeah, it's been great.
How about your co-stars? Anybody falling off their horse yet?
Not that I know of.
Safety first.
Yeah. I think one of our wranglers got rolled a few days ago, but I think he's all right.
Well, we know how to handle that kind of thing around here, so we'll take really good care of you, I promise.
I'm not worried.
And what have you been doing? I don't want to give any spoiler alerts about your previous work. How do you feel about some of your past roles and where you left your last big role?
Well, for me, the last role was a guest star, and you know, I'd done a few seasons of the show, and it was just time for me to move on. You know, I wanted to do something different. I wanted to try something new, and talk to the executive producers, and I said, this is going to be my last season, and they said, okay, and so they let me go, and since then, I did a couple of films, and you know, those have been really fun to keep you busy, and then took a little break, and now here we are.
What other genres do you think you're looking toward after this? Where do you think you might like to go?
Well, I'd really like to do a war movie. That's another big genre for me, and I'm a huge supporter of the U.S. military. I have family overseas, and you know, I almost joined the military myself when I was 19, so my path was different, obviously. It's taken a little different turn, but it'd be nice, I feel, for me to go back and sort of pay tribute to the people that are over there fighting to let me come here and play around on a horse.
Yeah, and you've got a great platform now to speak about that. You're going to reach hundreds and thousands of people, hopefully, who will stand up and support them as well, knowing that take your lead. Mm-hmm. So about New Mexico, have you ever been here before?
Once when I was very little.
Very little.
I don't remember it.
What were you doing out here?
We were actually skiing.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
See? The weather is nicer than just this. But I really, you guys are all troopers out here. I'm very impressed.
It's actually been really fun. You know, I rarely find myself in dust storms. So,
yeah.
Like on Tuesday when we were riding around, you know, all day shooting, and the wind was crazy on Tuesday. And you know, there were times you couldn't see 5 feet in front of you. And it just heightens the whole experience.
Right. And you're handling like a champ. I mean, I mentioned earlier, you just look so at ease and so comfortable here. I mean, I'm kind of wimping out already. But people don't know how hard it is, a long day on set. So
it's tough, yeah. Especially when, you know, you get off and you're picking dirt out of your ears. And, you know, it's gotten everywhere.
You're enjoying the crew out here? The
crew's been fantastic.
We've got some pretty hardcore film workers out here.
Yeah, crew's fantastic.
Obviously.
I was saying earlier, I think because it's a smaller film community, everyone works together a lot. Mm-hmm. And that shows from the very first day I was here, just the way that it all gelled, you know, with all of us coming in from LA, and it just all fit though, you know, and it's very professional. Everyone's really been great and nice and fun. And having a blast.
That's great. Yeah, everybody tries to have it down. Are you a fan of any New Mexico shows, like maybe Breaking Bad? Or
I do like Breaking Bad. I'm curious, they're shooting a new show out here called Preacher that I'm very interested in. So, and also another show, Midnight Texas. Both of those were shows that I was kind of involved with early on, and so I'm curious to see about it.
Yeah, so the Originals was part of that same author series.
Yeah, well, the True Blood was for the Midnight Texas.
Oh, that's right.
They were the same author.
Yeah.
And that, I think they just started out here, and I was, you know, going in for that initially, and it was sort of a nice little platform to go into, but it actually worked out better this way because I get to go in here and shoot an awesome western.
Well, there's plenty to do, so I hope you stick around. I mean, on set, and there's plenty of productions rolling, so I hope that we see you back.
I'm sure I'll be back.
Thank you very much for talking with us, and I just hope to see you soon. And we can't wait for this picture to come.
Me neither. It's gonna be fun.
Take care out there.
All right, I will.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.